to call Mr. Palash Nandi, CEO, Numeric.
So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Dr. Sai, for organizing an excellent event as usual. This is my third one. And you can see every year it's picking up as far as the scale is concerned, or the quality is concerned. So a lot of my colleagues of the industry have already spoken about the various things in terms of challenges that we face. I would like to take this opportunity to share, let's say, our experience about how we are going ahead in terms of trying to tackle this challenge. In terms of margin, the UBS industry is not necessarily the most interesting one, and especially for somebody from Legrand, where we are used to margins of 22% of operating income. The UPS margins are not necessarily the best. Having said that, it is a fact that it depends upon, let's say, individual organizations as to how they see this challenge and how they react or adapt to this challenge. So as far as we are concerned at Numeric or at the larger Legrand Group, we have a simple business model, which is saying that making profits is a very good thing. We should not absolutely be hesitant or apologetic about the fact that we should make as much profit as we can. The reason being that when you generate more profit, it allows you to come back and invest into the organization. And as a consequence, therefore, you have this cycle, which is always a positive cycle. So you make money, invest in the organization, whether in products, whether in R&D, whether in product development, people, etc., etc. And that's how you make the organization stronger, and that allows you to make more money down the line. So this is the simple model that we follow at Legrand, and this is what also we are applying at Numeric. And what we see that if we are ready to struggle a little bit more, if we are ready to not just be excited by the quick wins, then there is money to be made here. Just to give our experience, in the last 2 years, our margins have gone up by 3%. when we are investing into the organization. So you're spending money inside in the organization, and yet your margins are going up. So the margins are not going up by cutting or by reducing costs in terms of people, training, R&D, but margins are increasing when we are investing into the organization. But this calls for some hard calls to be taken, something which Sriram alluded to, that at some point of time, we have to come to a conclusion that the business model that we are following, is it something sustainable? Yes, it would give us some immediate results, but do we see over a span of 5 years or a span of 8 years, is this something sustainable? And if the answer to that is no, then don't do it. But this, I repeat, calls for taking some hard calls, and in 2016, we took some calls, and I can guarantee you that my sales guys were very angry at me. That no, this cannot happen, this is the way the model works, etc., etc. But coming back to say, yes, as Sriram pointed out, the model is that you make, let's say, relatively less money on selling the product, relatively more money on selling the services. But if we keep on delaying the cycle of the service, obviously, overall, we'll make less money. Plus, if I flip it around, that if we know that we will delay the cycle of service, then make more money on the product. So, sounds simple, But it requires, let's say, some hard decisions to be made, and we've made those hard decisions. So maybe in terms of pure percentage growth, we would not have been one of the fastest growing UPS organizations. But in terms of health of the organization, I think we would be one of the best in the industry today because of these hard calls that we have been taking. And this assures us that the business that we are building is going to be sustainable. Because the flip side is true that, I again come back to what Sriram said in his speech, that after many years, now the market is picking up. So it would be foolish if we don't take advantage of this opportunity because of this intense competition amongst us, which by the way is now increased because Arun has decided to enter the field. So welcome to this field of ours. So now we are going to do what is called as co-optition, you know, on one side cooperate, on the other side compete. But anyway, jokes apart, so there is quite a lot of opportunities after many years, and I also strongly believe that in the coming 3 to 5 years these growth opportunities would remain. And as an industry, it would be foolish for us if we let go of this opportunity. In the short term competition that we are involved in currently. So, let's say my suggestion, let's say my two cents would be that if all of us make a decision to build a sustainable business, then this concept of immense competition will naturally go. And this we have seen in other fields as far as Legro is concerned, so there is no reason why other industries that have been able to adapt themselves, why the UPS industry cannot adapt itself. Having said that, the other big challenge as far as we see it is this whole anomaly about this 18 and 28%. So it's like a dagger hanging over our head, and the more time it takes not to have a conclusion, this risk will keep on increasing. So apart from what I fully agree with RC, that between Exide and Amar Raja, I mean, there is a case to be made of 18% for batteries instead of 28. That would reduce the complexity of this invoicing, and in any case, batteries to be at 28% on its own doesn't make sense. I'm sure from the battery industry also they don't see this logic of why it should be at 28%. So this is a big challenge. The sooner we as an industry are able to tackle it, and I fully endorse Sriram, whatever you said, that as an industry, if we can approach the GST Council, it makes our case much more stronger than we individually wanting to do it. So, to leave you with a message that I strongly believe that it's good times for UPS industry in the coming 3 to 5 years. It is up to us how good we make it for our individual organizations. We have chosen to take a direction where profits would have preference over top line because we want to build a healthy organization that's sustainable and we can invest into the organization. So all of us will have to make our individual calls, but I again repeat, when the opportunity is there, this is the time to take the right calls. And on the other side, this GST remains a risk. Sooner we are able to solve it as an industry, the better it is for us. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, Dr. Sai, for having provided this platform. And all of you have a good evening.